Good afternoon everyone. I am Selma Begum, CSC department, DBSIT, Kavali. Today I am going to discuss about the mobile computing subject, unit 5. Coming to the topic, location discovery. So location discovery. So before going to explain about the location discovery, generally we have a GPS in sensor network in order to find the location of the nodes. But we have some power constraint network here. So power constraint network means there is a lack of using power due to the GPS is not properly working. So sometimes if we use GPS very good, then there is some problems in power failure. That wise the GPS will be fail always and it will be not work perfectly. So these are the problems occurred in the nodes when we are finding the location of the nodes. So if any problem is occurred in GPS with any mechanism, then how will we find the location of the sensor nodes? So that can be studied in this topic, that is location discovery. So coming to the location discovery, see here we are having a definition. So each node should know its location and merge the information with the data in the message. This is the my definition we are having. This is the definition we are having. So in this definition, the meaning is whatever the nodes we are having, that every node need to know its location. And whatever the message we are sending, I mean information to the other nodes, along with that information, we are going to match the nodes information also. And that information is sent in the form of message to the other nodes. That is called the location discovery. So this is the meaning of this definition. So once again, we are saying that this definition, each node should know its location and measure the information with the data in the message. Okay, so it means whatever the nodes we are having. For example, I am having the some nodes here. So these nodes should know their location. These nodes know its location, and whatever the information we are sending from this, along with the these location of the node will be node information also merged and send the data to the other node. So that is called the location discovery. In this we having two different types of types to find the location. One is indoor localization. Second one is sensor network localization. Coming to indoor localization. In indoor localization, we have a fixed infrastructure and it is used to estimate the sensor nodes location. So that is called the indoor localization. And in this, we are using some fixed beacon nodes that is placed strategically. So beacon nodes is nothing but it is periodically sending the message. It is periodically sending the messages. That is the beacon nodes we are going to use in this indoor localization. So when these nodes, whatever the beacon nodes we are using, that nodes should be placed in such a way that the area should be covered completely. So that is why we are providing the beacon nodes. I am taking a small example why we are using the beacon nodes in the diagram. Suppose I have a network here. Okay, this is one network. In this network, I have some nodes and one node A. Node A, I'm having some one network here. In this network, I'm having some beacon nodes. These are the beacon nodes. Okay. Bacon notes. These are the Bacon notes. I am having some other notes also here. Okay. So you see the one I am having. I suppose I have one small network here. In this network, I am having some Bacon notes and one node that is node A and some other nodes I have taken here. So now node A. Here problem is that node A doesn't know the location of these nodes. Its own location is doesn't know to the node A. So in order to find that, these Bacon nodes send the signals to the node A. This line only Bacon nodes. Here the Bacon nodes, we are having some Bacon nodes here. So these Bacon nodes send here signals to the node A. So actually remaining nodes also send the signals to the node A, but only we are just in this we are only focusing on the Bacon nodes. So these Bacon nodes send the signals, send the these Bacon nodes sends the signals to the node A. Okay. So these are the signals. When the node A receives the signals from the Bacon node, here we use some parameters. So these parameters is called strength, signal strength, signal strength. So if you see here, signal strength is one type of parameter we are going to use in this network. Signal strength is nothing but when we say our signal strength is very high, that can be declared regarding to that whatever the Bacon nodes here we are having, that is closest to the nodes. So that is why we are saying the signal strength is very high. So if me, for example, if we see our real time example, that is if you take one mobile, if the mobile have some high signal strength, then we say some antennas are very close to us, that like we think that. That like only here also I take one node here, node A. If this node having some signal strength from the Bacon nodes, so we have a, if we say the signal strength is very high, that can be depends that the nodes are very closest to that node. So that is called the signal strength. In this we having next parameter is angle of arrival. Angle of arrival. And third parameter is, and the second parameter is angle of arrival, and third parameter is time difference. Time difference between the signal and arriving from the sensor nodes. So these are the three parameters we are having here. These parameters are used to find the location of the node A. Okay, now this is the inter localization. Okay, so next, coming to second one, sensor network localization. In sensor network localization, we doesn't have any fixed infrastructure. So the whatever the sensor nodes we are going to use here, that nodes only acts like a sensor, Bacon nodes. So in this we having two types of signals. One is RF signal and second one is receiving signal strength indicator. So these two signals are used to find the location of the node. So in this we are using some techniques, that is multi-literation. So the multi-literation technique. Okay, so in this multi-literation technique, actually used to determine the location of the node. This is a multi-literation technique. ML is technique. Okay, multi-literation ML technique is used to determine the location of the nodes. So in this we are having some types. First one is atomic Lithium technique, we have in some types. First one, atomic ML. So atomic ML is nothing but for a node, for one node, it gets three different beacon nodes signals. For one node, it gets a signals from three other different beacon nodes. So for example, I am having one node here, and along with that I am having some beacon nodes, this one. So this is a node, and I get a signals from that beacon nodes. Okay, I get a signal. So this is a beacon nodes. These are the beacon nodes. Okay, these are the these three nodes are the beacon nodes, and this is one node. For this node, I am getting the signal from the three different beacon nodes. So that is called the atomic ML. Okay, so in these beacon nodes, we are going to use some parameters. Those two parameters are called, in previous only we told that is that parameters are, here we are using some parameters. Those parameters of RF signal, and second one is receiving signal, to receiving signal to determine the location. So these are the two parameters we are going to use in the communication when we are saying sending the signals. So this is called the atomic ML. Next, the second one is a iterative ML. Iterative ML means one after another node we are going to find the location. One location of the first one node of the location is fine. After that, another location of the node will be fine. That is called the iterative. If you see the small example here, having here some beacon nodes here and one node A, and these are beacon nodes sends a signals to node A, and yes, node A doesn't know the location of A. The A node doesn't know its location. So in order to find that location, he needs some signals. So some beacon nodes send a signal to that. So now A node knows its location. Now A node further sends a message to node B. Node B. And now node B wants to know its signal. Okay, already the B node has a signal of the node A, and B node also need two other signals from node B. If it gets signals from the node B or node E and to the B node, then B node's location also knows to this node. So this, like, first we are going to find the node A, and second we are going to find the location of the node B. This like the communication occurred between the iterative. One after another node will be find at the locations of the nodes. This is called the iterative ML. Next, coming to the third one, collaborative ML. So collaborative ML is nothing but two or more nodes. So two nodes are come to each other. They are collaborate with each other. That is called the collaborative ML. So if you see the small example, I have a node A here. For this node A, I am having two neighboring nodes, and I have another node, that is B. This node also having two neighboring nodes, and this A node and B node doesn't send with each other. The A node and B node doesn't send each other. So the both nodes will be send the messages. So some collisions will be occurred between that. Some collisions will be occurred here. So that collaboration will be occurred in that. So that is called collaborative ML. So due to that also, we also find the location of the node A and node B also. So these are the things we are used to discover the location of the nodes by using the location discovery. Thank you.